compassion means not only to feel one's pain, but also be moved to go and help them relieve it.
There is a part of Indian history that hasn't really been covered in history textbooks. We seem to have forgotten about it.
The part that we're talking about is the part of Indian history right after independence, where India grew under various leaders, both political and military.
They say that it takes a lot of courage and an even greater deal of experience to truly understand what compassion is. And Field Marshal Sir Manekshaw did have a lot of compassion.
In such a short video, it's impossible to do justice to all of Sam Manekshaw's achievements, but we will touch upon one of them.
In 1971, India fought in the Indo-Pak War, also called the Bangladesh Liberation War. India inflicted one of the largest surrenders in modern warfare, with Manekshaw at the head of the army.
India took 93,000 prisoners of war, among which 73,000 were uniformed personnel.
Now, this story is not a story of military achievements. It's a story of compassion.
Manekshaw made sure that all the prisoners of war were treated according to a certain convention called the Geneva Convention, which gave instructions on how prisoners of war should be treated.
Sam looked at them as a human being before looking at them as a soldier of an enemy.
Manekshaw wasn't compassionate because he treated the soldiers according to a convention. He was compassionate because of all the extras he did. He gave the Muslim soldiers Qurans, he gave them beds to sleep in, and he allowed them to write letters to their families.
The families of the captured soldiers were astonished when they heard that their boys were being treated with so much respect.
Manekshaw was criticized for this. The government, the media, and everyone else were against his move to do this.
But Manekshaw did something that it takes experience to do. He put himself in the soldier's shoes. He would want to be treated with respect, for after all, he did fight in a war.
He famously said, "Those chaps fought and they fought well. They deserve some sort of respect."
It's easy to forget what soldiers go through every single day. The battle is as much with themselves mentally, as much as it is with the enemy.
While we all live in our houses comfortably, we tend to forget that so many men and women live in such horrible conditions, just so that we can actually sleep in our beds.
One might think that defeating Pakistan is the biggest achievement of his career. Well, you would be mistaken.
If there is something that we can learn from his life, it's the understanding of the hardships that people go through that we tend to casually miss or conveniently forget.
During his whole career, from a second lieutenant to a field marshal, Manekshaw's biggest achievement was that he never punished a man. That speaks lengths about him.
He showed us how to look at everyone as our equal without any discrimination and how to treat everyone with respect.
He showed us that ranks, positions and age are not a justification to punish a fellow human being.
But most of all, he showed us the value of compassion is priceless. And that is a lesson we all can take from him.
On this Republic Day, let's all try to be grateful and compassionate and actually show people that we care about each other.
Let's learn to look at each other as human beings before anything else, because race, caste, religion, that does not matter. The only thing that truly matters is unity.